Now, we come to the 10th commandment in verse 15. And he says here, and it's a very wonderful one, "See that none render evil for evil unto any man." Now, this is something that I think is very important. And in other words, don't fight one another. Don't render evil to any man, but follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. Now today, as someone has put it, there are three philosophies of life. First, there is the standard that the pagan has today. This pagan world operates on a philosophy that you do evil in response to good. In other words, you get the other fellow before he gets you. You use any kind of a method. He may have treated you well, but if you can take advantage of him, you do that. That's a pagan heathen philosophy. Then there is the standard of the so-called, I suppose, refined and educated and cultured world, and that is, you do good to those that do good to you. Remember the Lord Jesus said, why, all these religious rulers, they always do good to those that do good to him. The Democratic Party and the Republican Party operate on that principle today. Somebody helps you get an office and you help him by maybe giving him an office. You know, you take care of your own. That's the philosophy of this so-called civilized world today. Now, the Christian faith has a little different philosophy. Do good to them that do evil to us. And my friend, that's contrary to the natural man. The minute that somebody hits you, you want to hit him back. You feel like hitting him back. And this is the philosophy that Paul is talking about here, that you are to not render evil to any man, but you're to follow that which is good, even to those that do evil to you. And now the 12th commandment is here in verse 16, and I think that you have three commandments that really go together. I've always felt that these go together here. In verse 16, rejoice evermore, or rejoice always. And it doesn't mean be happy. This is not the happy hour we're talking about. This is to rejoice. And Paul says in Philippians, and that he wrote at the end of his ministry, rejoice in the Lord, and again I say, rejoice. My, that's a commandment. You don't find that in the Ten Commandments. You have no right, my friend, as a child of God, to go around as a sourpuss. You've got no right to go around as a cantankerous individual. You are to rejoice evermore as a child of God. And how wonderful it is to be able to rejoice. And by the way, it is a fruit of the Holy Spirit, love, joy, peace. And if you can't rejoice right now, then begin reading the Word of God and calling on God to put joy in your heart. He'll do it. Rejoice always. And then, verse 17, pray without ceasing. Pray without ceasing. Now, this has to do with an attitude of prayer. That doesn't mean you to stay on your knees all the time, but I think that it means to pray regularly and to be constantly, I think, in the attitude of prayer. And then he goes on and says in verse 18, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Now, that's to give thanks in all circumstances, not once a year, but all the time. And he says, this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Now, if you would come to me and say today, what is the will of God for me? Well, I couldn't really tell you, but I can tell you three things here that's the will of God for you. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, and in everything give thanks. That's the will of God for you.